from Detroit Rock City at Gord Field, where it's an absolute free-for-all.
The stakes are high, and so am I. It's in the air tonight, Grim.
Remember, in the MFL, we encourage you to play with your food. He's probably lining up against you. The Midway Mutants battle the Motor City Maniacs. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Grim Blitzrow with you along with my partner, former player Brickhead Mulligan.
Hi.
And his life partner, the mini mutant head that lives on the shoulder of Bricks Jr.
Hey, you just threw up on my shoulder.
I don't often drink beer, but when I do, I get totally shit-faced. I am the world's most intoxicated man.
Say that again. And it's first and ten. And with a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first. Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. And it's first and ten.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And it's first and ten.
First down! I see this guy drop a lot of balls in the path.
Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. And it's first and ten. And the defense just caught, and the defender knocked the ball out when he was in midair. It is a fumble indeed. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. And they are schooling the defense right now.
Oh, my God, a man from prison just came onto the field.
That's the ref, you idiot. Let's see what the penalty is. First and ten. And that's the way you play a guy. Nice coverage. Second down and ten. He runs it for three. And that'll bring up third down and seven. Oh, great play. He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Bricks. Very smart.
The punter for today is being played by my kid's sister. He's got... Oh, what a punishing hit that was! And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and ten. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but... Oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot! That's why we love the MFL! Second down and nine. That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. Third and two. That ball just sliced through the defense like butter.
I wish defenses were made out of butter. That'd be.
And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can say that, Graham.
And it's first and ten. Hit. Well, that's a strange penalty called right there.
I'm starting to notice that this ref likes talking, and it don't make much sense.
No, but he's making a lot of dollars.
First down and less than eight. It's a jailbreak, and the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Oh, crowd's loving it. First and four. And he runs it in for the touchdown. Comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and ten. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and ten. Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first and ten. And the quarterback calls it. Kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. First and ten. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Second down and ten. warming up. Couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he put all of his foot into that one. Nice catch, and he turns on the... Oh, he just got crushed! And so at the end of one, we're all tied up. We'll be right back. Three on that play. Second down and seven. Just keep pounding the ball right up the gut and you'll tire these guys out. First down. And it's first and ten. Keep the drive alive as he rifles it in there and picks up 7 yards. Second and three. Man, guys like a freight train. Nice pickup there for a first down. And it's first and ten. In there for a 9-yard completion. They're moving the ball now with authority. And that'll bring up second and one. And I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. Boom, dead and down.
You delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Yeah, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's gonna be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
And it's first and ten. Up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
When the receiver runs away from the pass marker, that's a good clue that something's not right.
Down and eight. Defense was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. The cross-stitching, unbelievable.
He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Laid the wood on that guy. The ref calls a penalty. You know, the MFL has eliminated almost every penalty in the rule book, and yet it still feels like there's way too many penalties.
Stupid jerks. You guys suck.
first and ten. You know what they say? Sometimes gonna shave a few days off. Oh, you knew you were gonna see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. And that'll be second and eight to go. Conserve those runners now and consider passing more. And it's first and ten.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
First and two.
The boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times, honey.
2 minutes remain in the half.
Wait! I gotta take a dump!
Again? You just wet. How is that even possible?
It's the nachos, man! Want some?
And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown!
I think you ought to be able to shoot a guy in the end zone doing a dance like that. For extra points, you know? Plus, it would speed the game.
Good point.
Just one dirt as a paradox time.
You know, this shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and ten.
Oh my gosh! The defensive player looks...
No doubt about it. That guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. Breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They just be...
It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? He broke free and has open field in front of him. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players.
I'm pretty sure my baby sister can throw further than that, but she doesn't have to play against goddamn monsters.
Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he'd better win. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. And another interception. Oh, look at this guy break tackles. He takes, oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. option to try to conserve time. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult it.
First time out under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
That's right. What you talking about?
The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than completions. Pow! With the brain scrambler! And it's first and ten. Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Now, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed anyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Right now. What day is it?
Hold on. Looks like the offense has recovered it. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
Boy, these guys are gonna need to pull off a huge comeback in the second half to win this game. Here comes the kickoff.
Mip the coast! Why do we even come back and bother? This is a waste of my time!
Yeah, if only one team is gonna show up, why should we have to?
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. Knocked a pass down, and quarterbacks hate that. Second down and 10. And he breaks away.
Oh, man, he really won.
And that's some good old-fashioned downhill running. Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
And that'll bring up third and one. And that'll give him four more downs to punish the defense. And you better believe they will. And it's first and 10. Excuses for this QB. You just throw. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Great shoestring tackle. And it's first and 10. Receiver knocking down the antenna like Bricks' balls. He is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. Oh, stakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
With the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jet, you son of a bitch.
First and 10. At this point with multiple, and he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and 10. First and 10. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Get the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
And another interception. This quarterback is going to listen to Joy Division and weep tonight. Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting out with the vicious kill.
Did you know light hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schwong Galaxy phone.
And it's first and 10. Deflected the ball. Second down and 10. And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. Oh, and the ball falls to the ground. That's incomplete.
He needs to throw it when the receiver can catch it. What's he doing?
And groundbreaking analysis as always there, Bricks.
Thank you. I do my part.
Second down and 10. And that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grin. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Look at that little mutant run. Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. And it's first and 10. He's gone berserk. The ball carrier better walk. Oh, great play by the defense. The receiver didn't stand a chance. Second down and 10. I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some new ones?
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and 10. And with another pick, the QB says, I don't know what was thrown. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, it sounds like my offseason.
First and 10. Does the QB know? Oh, with a brutal hit. And it's first and 10. Defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
Second down and 10. And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection.
A man from prison just came out of the field.
It's the ref, idiot. Oh. Let's see what the penalty is. First and 10. They go to the ground game and pick up the first.
Man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass. That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. And it's first and 10. stuck to him like glue. Second down and 10. That was a good throw, assuming he was aiming for the ground. Third down and 10. Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
He's at the 40. The 30. The 20. The 10. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Rim?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
The third quarter mercifully ends. If this game is as painful to watch as we are to listen to, then please accept our apologies. This one is just about over.
I got the thing stuck in my ear again!
Defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. First and 4. Second down and 10. And that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. Mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill. And the defense gets another pick. Man, he's not going down. Boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
Quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. He's at the top, loose, but no cigar.
There's a bloody red head on the field.
No, that's their red penalty marker, Briggs. Looks like this one's coming back. And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. Quarterback pass this for a touchdown. And then, my friend, is the dance of someone who knows they can negotiate for more money next year.
I call that shake, rattle, and bone.
And here comes the extra point attempt. Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. First and 10. He could go all the way. He's at the 20. The 10. He might catch him.
Move, you fat little mutant.
Try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm.
And he's running like a... He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And it's first and 10. Blow up the defense today. Oh, hold everything. Looks like there's a penalty on the play. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. You've got to catch that.
A man from prison just came out of the field.
It's the ref, idiot.
Oh.
Let's see what the penalty is. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stop.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last three plays! Talk about luck!
punching them.
They'll be going onside here, and the return team is ready for it. No surprises here. They only talk about kickers when they win or lose games. Well, this guy just earned his paycheck.
Which is typically the amount the quarterback tips on dinner.
The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
You know, a lot of guys talk about stepping up their game, Bricks. He just stepped up and blew up. He's got a lot of guts, doesn't he? You can see the ground crew cleaning him up now. Hot potato gets him every time. And I've had it. Oh, nice hit. First and 10. Something, and he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And that'll bring up second and one. And first down. And the running game opens up for them and allows the passing game to be more of a threat. Gotta keep him guessing. And it's first and 10. And he just wrestles away from that tackle. Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. Since when is that a penalty?
Since now, I guess, Grim.
They're back up here on first, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Down in a mile. He picks up 8 yards on that pass. They quickly call a timeout, hoping to save some time for their offense. Second down in a mile. Oh, and he might have just saved a touchdown on that deflection. Down and forever.
Is the game over yet? I gotta go to the vet to have him reattach my big toe to where my thumb was again.
The defense calls a second timeout. They really need to make a stop here. Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. And he just lets that one go. He says, no, thank you. And the defense downs it. The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
picks up a new set of downs. And it's and that's the last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore.
Can any of us really stop the clock, Rim? I mean, when it comes right down to it, are we not all united by the constant reminder of our own mortality? Of death's constant, relentless advance? If only it was as easy as telling them, time out.
Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. Chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. Looks like they're lined up for an onside kick.
I thought they were going to do some sort of chorus line.
You usually only talk about kickers when they win or lose games. Well, this guy just earned his paycheck, which is typically the amount the quarterback tips on dinner. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a two-minute drill. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry-up.
Yeah, same as Britz's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sex. I took it as a compliment.
That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is... It looks like we've got a penalty here. Into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally took.
The Maniacs deliver a bloody win for the Motor City. It was a decisive win. The home crowd is cheering and throwing up at the same time. Too much excitement and booze will do that to you. And the players are celebrating as they search for missing appendages. They left it all on the field today, or most of it anyway.
Boy, you're not kidding. The blood and gut sucking Zamboni is coming out now. Hey, if anyone needs a liver transplant, there's a nice looking one down on the 40-yard line.
And let's hear what the MVP has to say.
Oh, I can't wait to hear what the most valuable prickhead has to say. Blah, 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 you suck. You tanked my fantasy game last week, you douchebag.
Grim Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Hard Corporation. They get it right every other...